Are you wondering how to migrate or move your WordPress website to another host? The problem is migrating a WordPress website can feel a little bit intimidating, especially if you've never done it before. I mean, where do you even start? The good news is in this video, I'm going to share with you how easy it is to move your WordPress website from one host to another in 20 minutes or less with a WordPress migration tool called Migrate Guru. And if all this sounds way too confusing, do not worry. If you stick around to the end, I'm going to share with you an amazing offer you don't want to miss. I want to welcome you to the WordPress Made Easy show. I'm your host, Jennifer Franklin, and I help entrepreneurs create and grow their WordPress websites quickly without stressing out over design or tech. If you're new here, consider subscribing and ring the bell to get notified of upcoming videos. There are a number of reasons why you may want to move your WordPress website to a new web host. Perhaps your website is really slowing down and it's slow loading, or maybe you're unable to update plugins without your website taking forever. Maybe your website is crashing a lot and you are noticing a lot of downtime. Your dashboard could feel real sluggish or slow. Or another reason you may be wanting to move your WordPress website to a new host could just be that your customer support is lacking and you're not getting your questions answered in a timely manner. I just want to let you know that I get it. Picking up and moving a WordPress website for the first time can seem a little bit intimidating and scary, especially if you've never done it before and if you are new to WordPress. That's why in this video, I'm going to share with you how easy it is to pick up and move your website. In this video, we're going to be using a WordPress migration tool called Migrate Guru. Now, you may be wondering why I chose Migrate Guru. In the past, I've used the all-in-one migration tool, and I just found that it would time out during migrations, or I would be limited with moving pretty small sites. They would not be able to be moved easily using the free version of the plugin. So when I discovered Migrate Guru, I have fallen in love, and I've had really, really great success with it. I've divided this process up into six easy to follow steps. First, I want you to back up your website. Next, I want you to choose your new web host and create an account. Third, we're going to log into your existing website and install the Migrate Guru plugin. Next, we will review your website once it's moved to its new destination. And then, fifth, we will switch the DNS record settings for your domain name. And then lastly, we will update and add an SSL certificate. The first step is to take a backup. Now, if you're not sure or you've never taken a backup of your WordPress website, I do have a video on how to do this using UpDraft Plus, and I can link up to that in the card as well as in the description below. You guys can check out that video, but it's really, really important. I want to encourage you to take a backup. Should anything go wrong, you want to be confident that you haven't lost your entire website. So that's really important. So make sure you go and take a backup of your website and then come back here and we'll pick up where we left off. The next step is to choose a new web host. In this video, I'm not going to get into too much about which WordPress website hosting company is the best. However, I can recommend three top premium hosting companies for WordPress websites specifically. They are SiteGround, WP Engine, and Flywheel. So let me take you over to each of those three companies' websites to kind of give you an idea of what I'm talking about so you can make the decision that best meets your needs for your business. First up is SiteGround. I want you to head over to Hosting and then WordPress Hosting. SiteGround offers a number of different plans. The one I want you to focus on for a new business owner for a new site would be the Manage WordPress Hosting, especially if you are a beginner to WordPress. They have a $395 per month startup plan. And you'll notice here that up to around 10,000 visits per month is allowed on that plan. It's easy to upgrade should you need to. I'm going to leave links to all three of these hosting companies in the description below, so you'll be able to check them out. Next up is WP Engine. Now, WP Engine is a little bit more pricey than SiteGround. It's probably the first thing that you'll notice. They do offer a lot more plans, though, to meet different needs. Their startup plan is $25 per month, and the amount of visits per month is up from 10,000 to 25,000 as compared to SiteGround. If your website is established and you're starting to get a lot of traffic and you're feeling like you really need to make a change to a better platform, then WP Engine might just be the good choice for you. And lastly, I want to introduce you to Flywheel. Flywheel is owned by WP Engine. And in my opinion, I feel like Flywheel is the perfect mix between SiteGround and WP Engine. The first thing you'll notice about Flywheel's pricing plans is they're right in the middle between SiteGround and WP Engine. Their tiny plan is ideal for small, simple installs. You can get started with Flywheel for just $13 per month. The reason why I use and love Flywheel is mostly because their beautiful dashboard. I absolutely love how easy it is to navigate their dashboard. It's easy to find things and it's clean and simple. Another reason why I love Flywheel is their amazing customer support. Have you ever submitted a request to your hosting company and then waited hours, days, what seems like forever for an answer? Well, that's just not been my experience with Flywheel. And that's one of the biggest reasons why I love and recommend their company for WordPress hosting. I am willing to pay a little bit more of a premium to know that if my website crashes, if it gets infected with a virus or hacked, that I can rely on someone to help me any time of the day to answer my questions. So if that's important to you, then I encourage you to check out Flywheel's. You can actually sign up for an account and get 14 days free trial just to give it a try. So you have nothing to lose, to just try it out and see for yourself. And again, I'll leave links to all three of these companies, SiteGround, WP Engine, as well as Flywheel, in the description below. So now that I've showed you three of my favorite WordPress hosting companies, let's get busy moving our WordPress website from GoDaddy over to a new account that we're going to create on Flywheel. In this video, we're going to be moving our website from GoDaddy to Flywheel. So to do that, we need to create an account on Flywheel. Here we are on Flywheel's website. And right here in the center, we can enter our email and go ahead and click on sign up for free. On the next page, this is where you will create your new account. They want you to enter your first name, last name, email, phone number, and then choose a username and password. This is the username and password that you'll use to log in to Flywheel's hosting account. Click on the I agree to Flywheel's terms and services and click on sign up. Once you've confirmed your account, go ahead and log in to Flywheel and click on create a site. Back over on my Flywheel dashboard, I'll simply click on create a new site, or up in the right-hand corner, I can click on new site. On the page that pops up, it just asks a few questions about our new site. Next, I'll enter my site details. For the site name, I'm simply gonna enter the business name of the website that I am moving. This helps me recognize what site it is. This is especially helpful if you have a number of websites that you're moving or you already have a portfolio of websites. Next, you're going to enter a temporary domain. I just usually use the business name, all lowercase, written together. If you leave this blank, they'll create a random temporary domain for you. Don't worry, you can change both the site name and the temporary domain once you create your site. Next, you'll create your WordPress username and password. What I like to do here is I like to use my current WordPress username and password that I currently use on the website that I'm moving. The reason why I do this is I'm really bad at passwords and usernames. So I like to keep the two the same. So that makes it super easy to log back in to once the website has been moved. Next, you will go ahead and click on Create Site. Once you click Create Site, Flywheel will show you the spinning wheel that they are creating your new home on the internet. The next step is to log in to your current existing WordPress website and install the Migrate Guru plugin. Over on my existing WordPress website, which is currently hosted at GoDaddy, I've logged in and we can go to the dashboard from the upper left-hand corner and we're going to scroll down to plugins. Click on plugins and up in the top, we're going to click on add new. Over in the right-hand side, go ahead and enter Migrate Guru and Migrate Guru plugin. The one that you want is over here on the left-hand side. That's by Migrate Guru. And go ahead and click on install now. Once it's installed, you can click on activate. Migrating your WordPress website to another host is made easy with the Migrate Guru plugin. The first step is to enter your email and click on the I agree to Blog Vault terms and conditions and privacy policy and click on Migrate Site. You'll notice down below that a number of hosts are supported. And you can see here that Flywheel and SiteGround and WP Engine, three of the top WordPress website hosting companies that I mentioned earlier, are all listed here. So it makes it super easy to pick up and move your website to any one of those WordPress hosting companies. Let's go ahead and enter our email and click on Migrate Site. On the next page, you will simply choose the host that you are migrating your website to. So in this example, I'm going to go ahead and click on Flywheel. On the next page, there are a few things that you might find a little confusing. I know I did the first time I used this plugin. So there are some helpful little prompts over on the right-hand side. For example, what is the destination site URL? So that's the first thing we want to find. We're going to need to reference our Flywheel account for this information. This is the site that we are moving our website to. So the destination site URL tells us that this is the URL, the site we are moving to. And that is, for this example, guineapigden2.flywheelsites.com. So I can simply click on that, click copy, paste that into the destination site URL. The next thing we need to do is the Flywheel URL. Now, again, we can ask this question over here. Where can I find my Flywheel URL? This is the URL that appears when you log into your Flywheel account and click on the destination site. So again, when we log in and click on this site, we would then easily copy the URL from the browser, and then URL is where we'd paste that. Next, we need to find the SFTP username. So to find those credentials, they are our Flywheel account, username, and password. Now, if you remember when you created your account for Flywheel, you created a unique username and password, and you're just going to go ahead and enter those here. Next, if your current website is password protected, then you will enter that here. Our current site is public, so there's no need to enter anything in this space. So I can go ahead and move on. In the destination website password, our destination site is password protected. They have what's called privacy mode, and I can easily turn this on or off. This is especially helpful if I am creating a site that I don't want visitors or search engines to find. I can turn on privacy mode. A username and password are automatically created for you. However, if you want to change these, you can change them at any time and then simply click on change. We'll just go ahead and copy the password and paste that in. Everything looks great. Go ahead and click on migrate. On the next page, the migration is beginning, and you'll see a little bit of a spinning wheel for a moment. Once your migration begins, you'll be able to see the progress in real time. The migration is working. As you can see here, the migration is beginning, and as the files are being moved, you can see it here in real time. Once you get that email that your WordPress website has been migrated successfully, congratulations. But just know you're only about halfway done. Next, we need to review your website to make sure that all the links, pages, posts, and media have migrated successfully. So let's head over to our new home on the internet and check it out. Here we are on our new home on the internet, and this is the new home of Guinea Pig Den, and we can take a look, make sure that everything is where it's supposed to be. And everything looks good so far. The next step will be to switch your DNS records settings. To do this will vary depending upon where you've registered your domain name. I'll leave a link to Flywheel's help guide that has instructions for various domain name registrars that can answer specific questions that you might have about your DNS settings. And if that all fails, feel free to leave me a comment below. I'm more than happy to help. And you can always reach out too to that amazing Flywheel support team that I told you about via the help button on Flywheel. The next step is to add your SSL certificate. Now, if you have your account hosted with Flywheel, this process is really, really easy. And bonus, the SSL certificate is included free with your hosting account. So let's head back over to our Flywheel dashboard, and I'll show you how to install your SSL certificate. On your Flywheel dashboard, over on the right-hand side, you would simply click on Enable SSL. Next, you want to make sure that the domain that you want to secure is correct, and then click on Complete SSL Setup. I told you I would have an amazing offer for you, so here goes. If you watch this entire video and you're like, no way, man, I am not about to try and move my website. This is too scary, too intimidating, or whatever. Do not worry. I want to offer you the opportunity to pick up and move your website for free from your current host to Flywheel. I want you to give it a try. And if you want to check this out, then go ahead and fill out the request form to move your website below. If everything looks good and I feel like we're a good fit to move your website, then I will reach back out to you and we'll get to work. All you have to do is click on the link below and give me a little bit of information about your current site and situation, and I'll be in touch letting you know how easy it will be for us to get your website packed up and moved to its new home in no time. So if you have any questions, of course, leave me a comment below. I hope you got a lot of value out of this video. If you did, go ahead and hit the like button. And if you're new here, consider subscribing and ring the bell to get notified of upcoming videos. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.